At the beginning of this year, Haval introduced a new member to the Jolion range, that being the Jolion S, which is what we have here. The vehicle gains a few cosmetic changes, slight bump in power, and a few revisions under the skin. We are going to take a look at the competition, what those changes really are, and how much they change the vehicle's personality, and how much it's gonna cost you to own and run. Welcome to a new video. The Jolion nameplate was introduced in April of 2021. At the time, I was doing my third year, and I remember mentioning to a friend that had I been in a position of purchasing a vehicle, I would have considered the Jolion. Personally, the reasons were straightforward. I've always had a dream of owning a Polo, and at the time, the pricing for the Jolion was similar to that of the Volkswagen, and it was around 300,000 rands and just below 400,000 rands for the top of the range model. But that was 2 years ago. The game has moved forward. New competitors have been introduced, and they've made changes to make sure that their car remains at the top of the list. And so exactly what changes have they made to the new Jolion S? Let's find out. The biggest change which they've implemented, it's the one which you don't see, and it's one which lies underneath the bonnet. So their 1.5 liter turbocharged mill has been given a slight improvement in power from the 105 kilowatts and 210 newton meters to what is now 130 kilowatts and 270 newton meters. The additional power is all thanks to an upgraded turbo. Despite all this, Haval still quotes 7.5 liters per 100 kilometers. And the Jolion S still uses a 7-speed dual clutch transmission and gains pedal shifters and launch control. Not that you're gonna use any of those. And now to the more obvious changes. The Jolion S gains gloss black elements here and there to replace the chrome finishes found in the other models. These include gloss black trim on the doors, lower front bumper, 18-inch alloy wheels finished in gloss black as well, roof rails, side mirror caps, and a new honeycomb grille. The boot lid also gains an S next to the Jolion badging. Unfortunately, it still does without any sort of electrical functionality. The boot in itself is spacious at 337 liters, which expands to 1133 liters with the rear seats folded. But still, it's unfortunate that there is no electric tailgate, especially when the rest of the interior finish is so beautiful. Not much has been done to give the cabin an S factor, but it was already a beautiful place to start with, so the lack of changes doesn't do the cabin any injustice. It's still a Jolion as we know it. The seats get artificial leather, but only the front items get seat heating. Other features include a 12.3 inch infotainment system with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, a 7-inch instrument cluster, two USB charging ports, a wireless charging pad, heads-up display, and a panoramic sunroof. What else do you get with the Jolion? Well, there's four driving modes. There's Sport, there's Standard, there's Eco, and there's Snow. And there's an additional three modes for the steering wheel, being Light, Comfort, and Sport. In addition, in place of the torsion beam suspension which is fitted in other Jolion models, the Jolion S features a multi-link independent rear suspension, and its creators say it improves ride quality, refinement, and handling. As mentioned, the Jolion no longer costs 300,000 rands. The S will cost you 489,550 rands, and this is how much you can expect to spend on the Jolion S on a monthly basis. And so with that being said, its pricing places it squarely on the playing grounds of the following competitors: the Chery Tiggo 7 Pro, Chinese. Then there's the BAIC Beijing X55, which, side note, its creators made it clear that when they made the X55, they were targeting the Jolion, another Chinese. Then there's the Corolla Cross GR Sport. And so with the Jolion S, what does 489,000 get you? Well, it gets you 6 airbags, ABS with EBD, brake assist, electronic stability control, and traction control. It also gets you lane departure alert, lane keeping assist, lane center keeping, blind spot detection, and driver detection, to name but a few. But unique to the Jolion S is pre-collision warning and automatic emergency braking. And for your convenience, there's tire pressure monitoring system, rear park distance control, a 360-degree camera, adaptive cruise control, traffic jam assist, traffic sign recognition, and keyless entry. Within the compact SUV segment, there's many options to go for. The Jolion has continued to top the sales charts for Haval. The Corolla Cross is doing wonders for Toyota as well. Same does the Chery Tiggo 7 Pro. So you can never go wrong with either of them. I think it all boils down to where you wanna put your money on. Otherwise, whichever one you go for, it's a win-win. The S is backed up by a 5-year 60,000 kilometer service plan and a 5-year 100,000 kilometer warranty. That's it for this week. Let us know what you think. Subscribe, leave a comment, share, and we'll see you on the next one.